Hello, dear friends. Thank you for tuning in on me again. And I pray God's blessings on this little short 10-minute message to your heart. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to speak to you on the fact that God's discipline brings deliverance. God's discipline brings deliverance. I want you to see the truth as revealed here in the Word of God. And the fact that God chastises his children. And the Bible says, what father does not chastise his child that he loves? Chastise means he disciplines and he punishes. It's really not so much a punishment as it is a training and a teaching. But it is a rebuke of the Lord when we miss the way and we need to learn to do right instead of wrong. And when we make mistakes, he has to teach us how to overcome that mistake and to do the right thing. And so God disciplines his children. And so we see in the book of Hebrews in the 12th chapter, it says, do not forget the exhortation which God speaks to you as his children. Now this is the secret. He's talking to his children. And so he says, because you are not to be discouraged when you are rebuked of him. For whom the Lord loves, he chastises. And he scourges every son and child that he loves. Therefore, do not be discouraged, because if you're not chastised, it's because you are illegitimate children. In other words, you don't belong to God. You belong to the old devil. Those out there in the world will be, they'll suffer, but they're not suffering at the hands of God as much as at the hands of the devil, because they don't belong to God. He's speaking to his children that he corrects and disciplines. And so the things we go through in life, we need to learn that God disciplines us in order to direct us and guide us. The book of Proverbs in the 3rd chapter says, acknowledge God in all your ways and he will direct your path. And so God's discipline brings direction. He will direct your path if you learn to trust him and acknowledge him in all your ways. Trust him in your thinking. Trust him in your speaking. Trust him in all your decisions. And God will bless you, guide you, and direct you. Now you'll have trouble and trials from time to time, but it'll always be a part of his training. And when you do the wrong thing, a part of his rebuke to teach you the right thing. Over in the Bible again, we read a good word in the book of James. I've often quoted, and that's in the 1st chapter of James. And it says, brethren, do not count it all joy. Count it all joy when you fall into different kinds of trials, because the trying of your faith works patience. The only way in the world we're going to learn patience is through trouble. And so God allows trouble to come sometimes in order to teach us that wonderful virtue of patience. Because if you had perfect patience, you would be complete, wanting nothing. You'd be completely satisfied if you were completely patient. And so it's important that we learn how to trust God and to believe God, even in times of trouble, that it brings us closer to him. The Lord allows troubles to come because many times when we try everything else and we're in trials and troubles and under the burden, that we look up and begin to call on God. And that's what he wants all the time. Oh, praise God. I think that perhaps the more closer you are to him, the less troubles you will have. But until then, you're going to have troubles to bring you closer to him. Closer to him. And so it's important, because he's dealing with his children. Jesus said over in Luke, the 9th chapter, if anyone will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. And so you see, you need to deny self. You need to get self out of it as much as you can. And think about others more than self. Think about others. I need to do that more than I'm doing. God, I'm asking God to help me. to love God with all my heart and to love others, even as myself, and to be concerned for others, love others. And so he says, take up your cross daily. And there he is, a cross. Cross is something that's not comfortable. A cross is something that is, bears with it a burden and a heartache. And so you've got to take up your cross and follow me, Jesus said. And then you will find life. For he that finds his life will lose it. You go your way, you live the way you want to live, and you're going to lose the real meaning of life. And you'll never find real contentment and the peace that passes understanding. But he that loses his life will find it. And so if you lose your life for Jesus, you'll find it. You'll find peace and power with God and men, and you'll walk by faith. And you'll not be afraid anymore because you belong to God. You're his children. Do not forget this exhortation as it is written unto you and spoken to you as God's children. God's children. If you're not chastened and disciplined, you're not really his child. You're illegitimate children. You don't belong to God. And so it's important to know we belong to God. Amen. I've often used this little illustration. When my son Ron was just a little lad, about 8 or 9 years old, I happened to look out the window, and he was playing with his little neighbor friend, and they were out there just fighting. They'd gotten mad at each other, and they were just rolling over and over in the dirt, just saying some bad words, and they were so mad at each other. So I went out there, pulled them up, and separated them. I said, "Now, you shouldn't do this." And I looked at Ed, and I said, "Ed, you go home." And I took Ron in the house with me to discipline him. You know? Now then, why did I send Ed home? Because he didn't belong to me. Why did I take Ron in the house and discipline him? Because he belonged to me. He was my son. And I loved him very much. And so God treats us that way. He takes us when we make our mistakes. And he sends the other back to the place of the world that he belonged. But he takes his children into his home, his house. He takes his children under his wing. And he disciplines them so that we'll learn to look to him. Until then, keep on believing. Until we get home. Until then, do not give up. Everything that's happening to you is for a purpose. God loves you very much. You belong to him. You're his child. And that'll never change. If you need to pray and ask God to come in your heart, you need to do that and say, "Dear God, please forgive me. I believe in Jesus. I believe he died for me. I believe he paid for all my sins. I repent of my sins. And I believe he rose again. I believe he's coming back. Come in my heart, Lord Jesus. Help me live for you." Amen. Pray a prayer like that and you'll live forever. And you'll know you are a child of God. You belong to him. And he's going to treat you and love you as his own child. Find you a good church and worship him with God's people. Praise the Lord. Keep on believing. Keep on believing. Oh, praise the Lord. Keep on believing. My heart will sing when I pause to remember this heartache here is but a stepping stone to a path that's winding always upward. This troubled world is not my final home. Until then, my heart will keep on singing. Until then, with joy I'll carry on. Until the day my eyes behold my Savior. Until the day God calls me home. Until then, our hearts will keep on singing. Until then, I with joy will carry on. until the day our eyes behold our Savior. Until the day God calls us home. Amen. May the Lord bless you, keep you strong, and remember, God's correction brings direction. God's discipline brings deliverance and direction. God bless you. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen.